no beef. Attention all 7th and 8th grade ladies.
We need you guys
to come out to the open gym, which will be, if you didn't get to make it on Tuesday,
it will be this Thursday,
4:45.
And next week, Tuesday and Wednesday,
same time,
at door 18.
And make sure that you request the late bus. So, a week in advance.
Yeah. But you guys, we need you guys. Please come. 7th to 8th grade girls. Thank you guys.
Yeah.
Welcome to the virtual Falcon Buck drawing. So if your name is on this wheel, you're all virtual, and you won Falcon Buck, you're doing something good in class. And as you can see, there are a lot of names on this wheel, so let's see who won. Spinning. Okay, Aiden Goldstein, congratulations, you have won the virtual Falcon Buck drawing. That's pretty impressive. Right, thank you. Just painting in the virtual Falcon Buck drawing.
Congratulations on winning the Steak and Shake gift card.
The following advertisement is intended for Jim Booney only.
Trivia question. When is the first academic pursuit meet?
No idea.
After school today.
Oh.
Good job, Emma. This is a call up for Aiden Doherty. Go to the academic pursuit meet.
That's really close. Oh, gosh. It's online, right?
Yes, it is virtual. Also, we still need 8th and 6th graders to join the academic pursuit teams. Go Falcons!
Contact Miss Floyd if you're an 8th grader, I think.
And contact Mr. Wilton if you're a 6th grader.
This is going very well.
On Sunday, November 8th, North Central held a virtual open house.
If you missed the open house or you just want more information, you can visit nchs.cc.
On this website, you can find virtual tours and alumni testimonials.
There's also a virtual information folder. The folder has many different topics that you can click on, and they will give you general info about each one of the topics.
We would like to give a shout out to Spelbo, who placed 15 out of 39 schools in our division. Out of 4 divisions, we placed 23rd out of 119 schools.
Special shout out to Kennedy Chandler and Zane Curtis for only missing 1 point. Even though we didn't make it to state, missing by 6 points, it's still a huge accomplishment. Good job, Falcons!
Hey, what's going on, Aaron?
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. Oh, not much.
Would you like to support my daughter's school and fundraise for us?
I'd love to. Let's see what they have. Ham and cheese. I've been missing them for a couple days. I'll buy 100.
Oh, wow. That's very, very generous of you. Thank you.
Anytime.
Look, you can get an Xbox.
Really?
Yeah.
And look, a Nintendo Switch Lite. Oh.
I wonder how my mom's doing.
Yeah, I wonder how my dad's doing.
Hey, how's it going?
It's going well, man. How's it going?
Oh, would you like to fundraise for my daughter Timothina's school?
I don't know, man. All my money's going to Aquafina. I mean, I guess I have $15 to spare. I'll buy something for Compton. He's a fat kid, so he'll want something.
Oh, that's nice of you.
No problem.
Hey Vanessa, how's it going?
Good.
Would you like to fundraise for my daughter's school?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Tom.
It's Timothy.
Sure, hon.
Hello? Hey, you there?
Yeah.
Would you like to fundraise for my daughter's school?
I can't. I'm supporting Kara's daughter's commercial.
Oh, that's okay. Right. It works.
All right, yeah.
Thank you anyway.
What are you doing, Timothy?
I'm fundraising for Timothy's school.
No, because Kaberchlin is doing that.
I mean, you know, we could both do it.
No, because you got the chance to talk to everybody before I could talk to anyone.
Oh, that's kind of unfortunate. You could always find other people. It doesn't have to just be the people at this office, you know? There's other departments.
Yeah, well, let's see what the supervisor has to say about that.
No, it's fine. We can both do it. It's going to the same place anyway.
Fine, but you're out of the carpool.
But what about Timothy Jr.'s lacrosse practice?
That's not my problem.
Oh, I guess that's fair.
Oh well.
I'm just gonna go. Have a good day, everyone.
You okay, buddy?
Yeah, I'm good.
Northview Middle School is having an Otis Spunkmeyer fundraiser. The sale started on November 6th and will end November 16th. You need to place all of your orders online, even if they're getting shipped to the school for you to pick up. In order for you to get more sales, you can talk to your friends, relatives, and neighbors, and go to www.clubschoicefundraising.com. Once you join the clubhouse, you can send the link to your relatives and they can help you sell. And can also get more prizes. And on purchases over $75, the shipping is free. Fundraise, people!
Veterans Day was created to honor all those who have served for our country, dead or living. It's different from Memorial Day because Memorial Day is time to remember who gave their lives for this country, rather Veterans Day can honor dead or living people. It's originally called Armistice Day, to show the end of World War I.
World War I, also known as the Great War, ended on June 28, 1919. But there was an armistice, or a temporary cessation of hostilities, 7 months before. That happened in the 11th month, on the 11th day, on the 11th hour. That's why we celebrate Veterans Day on November 11th. But it was first recognized as Armistice Day. On May 13th, 1938, Armistice Day was now a legal holiday. In 1954, November 11th became a day to honor all American veterans, no matter what war they served in. And that's when it was declared to be Veterans Day. Later that same year, on October 8th, President Eisenhower issued the first Veterans Day proclamation.
And it's celebrated by parades, church services, and the American flag decorating like everywhere. One of the most important things is the period of silence lasting 2 minutes that sometimes is held at 11 a.m.
Today we still honor Veterans Day as a celebration to honor American veterans.
You probably know that every year on November 11th, Americans celebrate Veterans Day to honor the millions of men and women who have served or are serving in the nation's armed forces. But bet you didn't know the whole story behind the holiday. For starters, it wasn't originally called Veterans Day, but Armistice Day, to commemorate the truce signed between the Allies and Germany in World War I on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month of 1918. The first Armistice Day in the U.S. was celebrated on November 11, 1919. All business was suspended for 2 minutes starting at 11 a.m., and parades and public gatherings were held to commemorate the occasion. Later, America also began honoring its unknown soldiers on Armistice Day, a tradition that continues today. At 11 a.m. every Veterans Day, a color guard ceremony represents all branches of the military at the Tomb of the Unknowns in Arlington National Cemetery. In 1954, the name was changed to Veterans Day, following a national campaign to have the day honor all veterans, not just those who served in World War I. And did you know, for 7 years, Veterans Day was actually celebrated in October? In 1968, Congress moved Veterans Day to the fourth Monday in October so that government employees could enjoy a long weekend. But in 1975, President Gerald Ford returned Veterans Day to November 11th due to the historical significance, and that's where it sits on the calendar today. And do you know the difference between Memorial Day and Veterans Day? Both of them honor those men and women who have served in the military, but Memorial Day honors America's war dead, while Veterans Day honors all American veterans, living and dead. The U.S. Census Bureau estimates that there are currently over 21 million living military veterans in the United States. More than 16 million of these served during times of war, while 5.5 million served during peacetime only. So this Veterans Day, don't forget to say thanks to some of the millions of men and women who have served our country.
Let's check it out. Shut the camera off. See the batteries.
Check it out!